What's going on, guys? My name is Pedrotsky, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use schedules inside of Pterodactyl. Now, why am I making this video? Well, one question I've gotten over and over again is how can I set my server to restart every single day? Now, it might seem simple enough for most people if you're familiar with crontab, but for just like someone starting out, it's going to be difficult. So basically, this assumes you already have Pterodactyl set up, obviously. If you don't, go on the description. I've got a video there, you can check it out. It takes like 5-10 minutes to get it installed on your game server. But once you've got your game up and running, all you need to do is go into it. So we're going to use Quake Live for an example. We're going to click on Schedules. Then we're going to create a schedule. So this one here, I'm just going to call it, let's say, Daily Restart. Now, this is where it gets confusing for people because it says minute, hour, day of month, day of week. Now, this is basically a crontab. So I'm going to leave a link in the description to this site here called crontab guru, and it pretty much turns that cron time into like a readable time. So let's say you can't change everything out. So it's pretty simple, like once you just sort of get the idea of it. So you've got star here as any value, you've got a separator, a range of values, steep values, etc. For the most part, you're just going to be using stars and numbers. So stars pretty much represent, like, let's say star under day, it means every day. Star under month is every month. Let's say we only want it to run in January, for example, we'll change it to one, month one, February, month two, but obviously we want it every day of every month, so we'll leave that as star. And then let's say we want our server to restart at 6 o'clock every morning. So you can change the hour to 6, minute to 0. A lot of people put star in, which basically means the server's gonna restart every single minute, but you'll just set that to 06 star star star, which is 6 o'clock in the morning every single day. So once we go back over to Pterodactyl, so we've got minute, this is like every 5 minutes basically. So we're gonna change this to 0, change hour to 6, and then only when server is online, and yes, we want the schedule to be enabled. So let's click create schedule. And then we go into the schedule. So once we're inside the schedule, we can add a task to the schedule. So if we click on new task, so it gives us a few different actions here. So there is, like, you can obviously run a command, send a power action, which is obviously start, restart, stop, and terminate, or create a backup. So most of the time you want to do send power action. And basically it's as simple as clicking restart the server and then clicking create the task. So that's pretty much it. And if we run now, it's basically just going to restart the server. So we'll see it's restarting the server. Now, there's a few other things to take note of. Sometimes if you've got a server and it's got lots of plugins on it, for example, the server's not going to shut down normally. Like, you have to stop the server and then you have to kill it. So the way around that is to actually terminate the server. So let's edit this task. We're going to edit this power action. So we're going to edit the power action. And then it says here, send power action. We're going to terminate the server. And then we click save changes. And then we're going to add another task. We're going to add an offset to this as well. So let's say from the time the server gets killed, we want to wait like 10 seconds. And then we send a power action and then start the server. And this one here as well, we probably just want to have continue on failure as well. So that means future tasks will be run if that task fails. So this means the server is basically going to force shut down and then start. Now, if you're running most of the time like a vanilla server, you're not going to run into this issue. Your server's going to restart fine. But like, for example, our zombie escape server has something like 150, 160 plugins. And to diagnose what is stopping that from shutting down, it's just a lot easier to just like pretty much kill the task and then just start it again. So that's pretty much it. And as you can see, if we run that, it's just pretty much terminated the server, and then we're going to wait like 10 seconds and then the server should hopefully start up. So there we go, the server's starting. So it's pretty simple. The main thing is it's just playing around with the crontab and just literally just have a play around. Like it's not hard once you figure it out, and it's just one of those things you'll just go, oh that does this, like, and there's so many different expressions you can use, but don't be intimidated by it. Super simple to use, and there's a reason why Pterodactyl does it this way. It just gives you a lot more control just with a few numbers. So that's pretty much it, guys. If you get stuck with your schedules, just I'll leave a link to my Discord group down below and you can come and join us. We've got plenty of people that help you out in the tech support channel. And if this video was helpful, just give me a like, comment that it was helpful, or subscribe. So that's pretty much it, guys, and I hope to see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.